That's the final question before we wrap up.
My question is to Akash Da. Hello, I'm Gaurav. I'm from Guwahati itself. I am especially why I asked to Akash Da is I am a Patreon at the Deshbhakt. What I wanted to ask is that the role of media at the time when we see that people like you or Dhruv Rathi or Kunal Kamra or etc., many of you have started your own channels. Many of the senior journalists have left their offices just to due to certain reasons and they need to start their own channels. Yet, the people who watch your channel, it's, I mean, if we compare it to the population of India, it's very less. At the same time, there are channels which might invite Baba Ramdev and they do some shows with this one, I mean, which are not expected on television. There are channels which might run something or the other, where I have seen a recent statistic that most of the shows are on Pakistan versus India.
Sure.
So what I mean to say is, well, how do you see the role of the media in the growth of the nation?
I think both of us can answer this question because we also have a media person here with us. Wearing your media hat before I answer that question, wearing your experience in the media and having seen the media, what sort of media and the role should the media play today, given the fact that we are living in very divisive times where fake news is perhaps more popular than real news?
No, but for the purpose of opening up the borders and having the economy grow through the borders, through the economic borders into South Asian countries, I think the media has a lot of potential to be exploited. You know, I was 40 years in the media myself before I joined politics. So our efforts have been to try to, you know, inculcate a sense of employment opportunities among the youth, that you can take this trade, that you can take this venture into this direction, so that you get more benefits, so that it may be a new venture, it may be something different which others have not taken, but you have the, if you have the will, there is that potential. So this where media can come in. Media has to motivate. Media has to motivate. Media is not just for broadcasting fake news.
Correct.
Or manufactured news or whatever, but media is there to motivate. Media is there to enthuse our youth to see that, well, we can take up this. Well, this is the venture. This is where some others have already met with success, that they have achieved a lot, they have done this, that they are earning this, they have risen to this. This is where the media has to, you know, show examples.
Okay, now since he is a Patreon, and Patreon is a system where people support us, so we are like 100% crowdfunded model. Now his question was, and I have to answer you because that's the rule of our platform, is if a Patreon asks a question, then it has to be answered. Just taking off from what Sir was saying, is that media continues to have its role. Yes, today fake news is very, very popular. I am not doubting that. Yes, today serving trash to the masses is working. But trust me, genuine media always has had its place and will continue to have its place. Yesterday's example only, what happened in Hyderabad, immediately the fake news guys swung into action, tried to communalize the incident. It's only within a few hours that we got to know what the reality is, that it was not a communal incident, the woman wasn't targeted because of her religion, or they were not perpetrators of one single religion. What will happen is, eventually, you see, technology is always misused in the first go. Remember all the MMSs, I mean, you guys would not remember, but when MMS became a technology thing, it was misused to violate privacy of people first. Then people understood the technology. It's the same thing that is happening with WhatsApp, that we are blindly believing. And my request to the audience here is, if you receive a message on WhatsApp, and if it's a shocking bit of news that you receive on WhatsApp, then it's fake. Just fake. If you receive a piece of news on WhatsApp without a link, without a website, without a reference point, it's fake. Unless until you prove or verify it is true. What is happening today is, you receive a stunning piece of news on WhatsApp, let's forward this. And that's the mentality that is winning. But that mentality will lose. And you know what? This is actually swinging elections. And politicians have to be very, very wary about this. We have seen what has happened in the American elections, for example. It was swung. We know how Brexit was swung. There are people who are working in the background. Where do you think those emojis and those cartoons are making fun of politicians are coming from? Somebody is sitting at home and making it. There are factories where this is being manufactured. You are being fed something. And whatever your political belief is, on our platform, we have never, ever said vote for this or don't vote for that. Whatever your political belief is, we only say one thing. Question what you are consuming. Question why did this come? Who has sent this? What is the story behind it? If you do that, you will turn out to be much smarter individuals. And you know what? A lot of conversations these days get ruined is because somebody will say something stupid in the middle of a conversation, which is basically information derived out of WhatsApp. And we've actually called it something also, Whatsiyappa. So stop the Whatsiyappa, you know. Thank you.